All right, so let's talk about a trip that I had in my Ford Mustang. I was going to the Diplomat Beach Resort from Winter Springs, Florida. This is about a 240-mile trip in my Mustang Mach-E. This is the first trip I'd made that would require me to charge along the way. Now, I've had this vehicle since February of 2021. We moved from California to Florida. And so we're moving from Winter Springs down this I-95 corridor to the Diplomat down here. I'll pull it up here. This is our final destination. You can see the route. Pretty developed area. So I thought, yeah, why not give it a shot? My wife has a Tesla. She's like, hey, you want to use a Tesla? I'm like, no, let me try the Mustang. I'm by myself. I'm good. Let's give it a shot. So that's what I did. And I'll just tell you where I started and where I ended. The first stop from Winter Springs, and the Mustang I have gets around 280 miles on a full charge. And we had to go 240. So obviously I had 500 miles roughly to get there and back again. My first stop was in Port St. Lucie. Now let me put the EV charging up here from Google. And you can see the destination charger down here. I think this is the right one. That's a Tesla supercharger. Maybe this is the one here. Oh, I got a story about that one. That charge point is not something you want to do. They're rough there. I don't know. I can't find my. Got it on here, but maybe it's not showing. It's an Electrify America is the one you want, by the way. So, and I don't know why we don't show the one in Port St. Lucie. Let's see what we got. Electrify America, Townsend Road, EVgo. This one doesn't have it. Apple had it. So, you know, this illustrates the entire point. The where I started, where I charged at was in Port St. Lucie. I am not seeing that here along my route. Let me back out of electric charging real quick. This illustrates my whole point is, you know, we're in a good place with electric charging, particularly now that Tesla is going to allow people in. But this is where I stopped along the way is in Port St. Lucie, right in this area here. There's a Walmart right in this area here, which is an Electrify America. Now, I'll show this. You can see this on my Apple or my Ford map, which also, by the way, was on my iPhone maps, but I'm surprised Google doesn't have it. Let's look again. Maybe I just missed it. Let's see if this is the Walmart right here. Because this is it. So it was on the list. And why I didn't find it. Yeah, Walmart Supercenter. Now, this is in no way representative of the charges. This is a beautiful one. I've got a picture of it. I'll put on the screen here. This was a great experience. The Walmart, it was safe. It was great. No problem at all. So I really had a good experience at that. So I highly recommend this charging station in Port St. Lucie. That kind of is the halfway point. Excuse me. It's halfway point between here and where my destination was. So right in this zone here. So it had a good spot. That's a good location in either direction. Now that was the easy part, getting down there. Once I was down there, I got to the hotel property, both, and I'll flash this up on the screen when I do the edit. Both of these charging stations that were at the hotel, the SEMA Connect, were dead. They were both inoperable. I went to talk to the manager. I said, hey, I really need to get this charged so I can get out of here safely and effectively and go back home. Nothing happened. And so the Hilton property owners didn't have the property conditioned properly for charging. I couldn't charge that night, so that before I left the night before, I had to go across town 7 to 8 miles, which is about a 30-minute trip when you're in this Hollywood area in Florida. It's a very dense area. And you know, you'd think there's charge points everywhere. There's not, because in my destination, they do not have any. They the SEMA Connect charging stations. Both of these charging stations were down. They were inoperable. So I think that's part of the other issue that we have is inoperability of charging stations when we find them. So short story here is I had to go across town to an Electrify America. I don't even know that Google's going to show it on here, but it was about a 7 mile journey from my hotel down in this Hollywood area. I had to leave the property, go to Electrify America charging station, and then come back up. Now, on the way back, so I was thinking that I would go back 95 and I would hit the Electrify America charging station in Port St. Lucie after, because remember, I had to charge locally in Hollywood. I had to drive a car across town to charge locally to go back to my hotel because the property chargers weren't working. And the place wasn't that bad. It wasn't in a very savory area. But there were four really high quality Electrify America charging stations. Went back to the hotel, did my overnight stay, took leave of the hotel property, and coming back. Now, what I didn't realize on my way back, and I want to make sure I reference this properly, I had a charge point station, and that charge point station, one of the two stations, it was at a Wawa, and it was at Vero Beach. So it was at a Wawa at the Vero Beach exit. And I just blew past the Port St. Lucie charging station. I wish I had stopped there. I'm going to give you this advice, and probably this is the most important advice that I can give. Check your preferred charging stations before you get in the car. You know, automation is a beautiful thing, but I blew right past it on the map. I thought I was going there. I thought it was pre-programmed to that. They were taking me so far north of that charging station. So I ended up in Vero Beach trying to figure out where I'm at here, because I'm really not familiar with this geography. Lake Worth, Boynton Beach. So we go back up and take this trip virtually. EVgo, I blew past this, blew past Delray Beach. I blew past this area here in Lake Worth. Palm Beach, way past Palm Beach. So, you know, you see lots of charges. Tesla's a plenty, by the way. Tesla, you guys who drive a Tesla, you're in really good shape. You don't have any real substantive problems for charging. And there's an Electrify America saying, now this is where I would have stopped on the return trip, but I didn't. So I kept going north. I didn't, you know, again, I blew past it. And I was just on autopilot because I was following my map. Kept going. I'm going to see if I can find them. Giving you guys a long map tour of Google. We're getting in this area here. So somewhere in this area here, there was a charge point. I'm not sure why they don't show the charge points. See, I'm going to give another search on Google. There it is, right here. So this was a supercharge. This was a charge point charging station at a Wawa. And no, that's not it, because it's Bass Pro Shops. Yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to, this goes to the point, because this is Vero Beach. This is where I was at right here. And Google Maps is not showing this charging station, but there was a Wawa at Vero Beach at this exit right here. This is the Wawa. You notice there's no, I've got the electric charging. And again, this goes to the point. Google doesn't show this, but Apple does. My Ford app does. And there is a charge points, two charge point stations here. Pretty nice charge point station. One was inoperable. It was 11:45 at night when I got there. And of course, when I pulled in, there's a dude in there. I went over and looked at his car, and he's at 20%. So there's 20 to 45 minutes sitting there waiting for that dude. Then I get mine, and I had a terrible time. And I'm going to tell you about the charge point chargers. I had the app. The app refused to start the charging process. And I kept getting this red mark on my Mustang charge point, on my charger, where you insert the charge device into your car, and it kept going orange. I said, my goodness, what is happening here? So in any case, finally got it to charge because I swiped a credit card in front of the reader. It wasn't apparent that I could do that. It said charge point card, not credit card. So I swiped the card, got started. So that was about over an hour to an hour, 20 minutes, me sitting there waiting at that Wawa. That was my last hope. I was in no man's land after that, because there were not many charging stations that were on the map that I could find. So if that hadn't worked, I would have been a world of hurt. But I did get home. I rolled in at 16%. I can tell you, if you get a chance to charge to 100, don't charge to 80. Because a lot of times the applications will tell you charge to a certain amount. Charge to 60% to get home. Charge, and you're in a hurry, you want to get off the charger, you want to get on the road, charge a little bit higher than it recommends. So I finally got home that night, rolled in at 2 a.m. because I left at 9:30 or 10, can't remember. But it was a long night because of the charger. So it really, my final advice, plan your route, check the charging stations if there's reviews. Electrify America rocks. I really recommend that you build your trip around Electrify America. At least that's my experience on the I-95 corridor from the Orlando area down to 95. Tesla superchargers are plenty. If you're Tesla, you're good. Tesla is offering new non-Tesla chargers in our Tesla app. I see it. I just couldn't use it because at that same Wawa, there is a Tesla supercharge center with 8 ports. You don't see it on the Google map, did you? But it's there. And There were no non-Tesla available for that particular charging station. Listen, I know this is a bit verbose. I just wanted to show you my experience and overlay some of this. I'll try to show some of the images on the map where it's in the video properly. Thanks for listening. I hope it was useful.